taking the best from an impoverished childhood and developing an innate talent into international superstardom, the life and career of the man known as America's Super Picker, Roy Clark, can only be described as extraordinary. Born with music in his heart in 1933 in Meharon, Virginia, Roy Linwood Clark is the son of two amateur musicians. Roy's interest in music surfaced at the age of 11 when he began playing around with his father's tenor banjo. Practicing his instrument so much that his fingers bled, Roy won two national banjo championships and, at the expense of his schoolwork, was simultaneously pursuing both his music as well as a career in baseball and boxing. After appearing on local radio and television, however, when an invitation to do a guest performance on the Grand Ole Opry came at the age of 17, Roy Clark dedicated himself solely to his music. After spending a year in Nashville working with Grand Ole Opry stars such as Grandpa Jones, Ernest Tubb, and Red Foley, in 1951, Roy Clark returned to the Washington, D.C. area where he could play not only country, but pop, jazz, and rock and roll as well. Roy joined Jimmy Dean's band in 1954, appearing as a regular on Dean's Town and Country Time television program. After his habitual tardiness caused Dean to fire him, at the age of 27 and out of work, it was Wanda Jackson's offer for him to come to Las Vegas that turned out to be a turning point in Roy Clark's career. Fighting a chronic lack of self-confidence, the following year saw Roy work diligently as he developed his unique, standalone talent as a multi-instrumentalist, singer, and comic. His path to stardom nearly complete, in 1962, Roy signed with Capitol Records and released his first solo instrumental album, The Lightning Fingers of Roy Clark. The early 1960s were pivotal in the career of Roy Clark. After appearing on The Tonight Show and seeing his instrumental recordings enjoying significant airplay, Capitol executives quickly capitalized on Roy's ability as a vocalist, releasing his first hit vocal recording, The Tips of My Fingers, in 1962. Clark's rural sense of humor was equally effective when he played dual roles on numerous episodes of the Beverly Hillbillies. With unquestionable momentum, by the late 1960s, Roy Clark's career was on the verge of a full-blown explosion.
When did you leave Bug Tussle, Roy?
Early Monday morning, Granny.
That's a good time of day. And now that we've passed it, let's hear some music.
In September of 1968, CBS producers approached Roy with the idea for a show that was a country version of NBC's hit Laugh-In. Saying yes to the concept, Clark was stunned when his manager called and said, "They're getting ready to do that show." Clark replied, "What show?"
Welcome to Hee Haw, starring Buck Owens and Roy Clark.
The show he'd forgotten he agreed to do, Hee Haw, went on the air in June of 1969.
I'm Buck.
I'm Roy.
Let's go.
Universally panned by critics, Hee Haw was an instant sensation among the public, making Roy Clark the face of the banjo for a generation. Despite its high ratings, CBS canceled Hee Haw in 1971. Moving into syndication without missing a beat, Hee Haw went on for another 20 years, making it the longest-running weekly syndicated series in history.
Hee-haw!
Yesterday, when I was young, so many happy songs We're waiting to be sung.
With Hee Haw firmly establishing him as an American entertainment icon in the 1970s and 80s, Roy Clark came to symbolize country music to a new generation. He toured constantly, often selling out the showrooms of major venues in Las Vegas while upholding his country roots as a member of the Grand Ole Opry. In addition to Hee Haw, Roy was a regular on numerous talk, sitcom, and variety television shows, including becoming a regular guest host for Johnny Carson on The Tonight Show.
Rocky Top, Tennessee. What a wonderful world.
An unlikely international emissary of peace and goodwill, in 1976, Roy Clark became just that as the first country music artist to perform in the Soviet Union. After hosting a delegation of Soviets in Las Vegas, Clark was invited to tour their country, ultimately playing 18 concerts to sold-out audiences. Following the tour, the State Department praised Clark for opening diplomatic doors which had been closed for decades. When he returned to Russia in 1988 by invitation of Premier Gorbachev, Roy Clark was hailed as a hero. Although he's a member of the Country Music Hall of Fame and the recipient of every award and honor his industry can bestow, Roy Clark's decade-defying success can be summed up in one word: sincerity. A sincere smile, a sincere wit, and a sincere love of music as well as his audience. But there is more. His performances touch listeners with a personal connection that comes from within and extends far beyond music and laughter. Simply put, Roy Clark is a unique and truly once-in-a-world performer.